Hey there and welcome. My name is Mr. Barry, and today I want to be looking at something a little bit different than we usually do. Normally we are going in and looking at ways to better use our Chromebooks and maybe even our cell phones and other things using the apps that we find on the Play Store as well as the Chrome Web Store. But in this whole video, I'm going to be looking at security tips for keeping you safe on your Windows 10 computer. So let's get on to the Selma Teacher Training, you and I. Come on. Hey, here I am in my Windows 10 desktop. Now, the very first tip for keeping safe online or keeping your Windows 10 secure is to check for updates. And many of us check the Windows updates, but we need to do more than just check the Windows updates. We also have to check any of the programs that you use to really work with. So I'm looking at the browser, and I'm going to show you first off how to check your updates on your Windows computer, and then I'm going to go into the browser and check updates there. Now you can also check updates for if you're using Adobe software or other types of important work that you work with every day. You make sure that you get those updated so that you stay safe. So let's go ahead, and now we're going to click down at the very bottom here of the Windows 10 desktop, and I'm going to type in update, and then now open up the Windows update options. Now within this window here, this is where we can click on check for updates, and it will check for updates. Now it automatically does this for us, but it's always good just to make sure that everything is working properly here. And as you can see, even though it said it was updated, when I clicked on check for updates, it actually found a new malicious software removal tool, which it's now installing. Next, I want to check the updates on the browser. And this is because really many people are now using the browser more and more to do more than just email or social media, but they're actually using it to do their work. So go ahead and click on the Customize Control Google Chrome, the three dots up here. Bring this down and then go to Settings. From within the Settings window, click down here where it says About Chrome, and it says Google Chrome is up to date. Now if it was not up to date, there would be a button here that you can click on and it will actually update it at that time. And our next tip is that you want to make sure that your firewall is enabled. Now if you have Windows 10, by default the firewall is always enabled, but hey, you want to check it just to make sure, right? So all you got to do is go down to the bottom of your desktop here, and then in that box type in firewall, and the firewall settings will come up. Go ahead and click it, and it opens up here. Now you have two different types of connections that you can be connected to. You can have the private network, that would be like if you're at your house, and the next one there is a public, and that one would be if you're connected at work or maybe at a restaurant or something. Basically you want to make sure that on both of those settings it is turned on there, as you see there. And the next tip that I want to share with you is that you do want to use some type of antivirus or anti-malware software. Now by default you do have Windows Defender built into your Windows, so that's awesome to have, but I do recommend having other ones as well, such as Malwarebytes. Also you can have Super Anti-Spyware, and those two along with your Windows Defender can really keep you safe there. And I would like to mention too that if you are using Malwarebytes or something like anti-spyware, you want to make sure that that software is always updated very frequently as well. And the next tip is about passwords. Now a lot of times we use maybe the same password to get into our email or to our social media or into other things or other accounts that we have. That is a very bad idea. You want to have a unique password for your email, for logging into perhaps your Windows account, logging into your Google account, going into your Facebook and other places. You want to have unique passwords. And you can use a software that can actually help you. One good software is actually called LastPass. And this is not a video talking about LastPass or being paid by LastPass, but it is a good program that I use and some of my students do use it. And what it does is basically whenever you create a new account and you have to create a password that goes with that account. LastPass can help you create a very long, complicated password that has both letters, numbers, and symbols there, as well as uppercase and lowercase letters. And it will actually remember that password for you. So next time you go to that website or go to log in to that specific area, it'll actually help you and put that password in for you. So that's called LastPass. And the next tip that I want to share with you is about email. Now, we don't want to open up any suspicious email. And sometimes you might receive an email that looks like it's from a bank, or it looks like it's from some place like Yahoo or Gmail or something like that, but it's not. And you can really look at it, and if you're suspicious about it, don't open it. Instead, log into your Google account the way that you normally do. Don't use that special email to log into your account. And if you're really concerned about it, you can contact the bank or other institution that you believe is sending you that mail just to make sure. And you also want to be very leery of sharing information online. So when you go to a social media or when you go to other places and you're typing in, filling in information, you want to be aware of where that information is going. So if it's something personal you don't want to share, don't share it. If you feel suspicious about it, don't do it. Your safety and your privacy always comes first. So if you're suspicious about it, don't enter in that information. And next, if you're purchasing things online, you want to use Amazon or another reputable store that actually will have some backing to it. And if you're buying things, usually you want to prefer perhaps PayPal. And you don't want to give people out your credit card number, that's for sure. So don't give out credit card numbers. Instead, we're using something like PayPal to protect us and protect our purchases. And the next tip there is, when you're browsing on the internet, you do want to be very, very leery of going in and just browsing, you know, for anything. You want to be aware of where you're going, so that whenever you go to a website, you should see a padlock up at the corner. So I'm going to focus in on that right now. And you notice there's a padlock in front of my URL address there. That should be there if it is a site where you're going to be working with, such as putting in any information or anything like that. If it doesn't have the padlock, that means that that website is not using encryption software, and you don't want to use that. And the next tip for Windows 10 is, you want to stay away from pirated software. I know it's all too easy to find pirated software anywhere on the internet, but you don't want to use it. Why? Because a lot of times that pirated software has something a little bit added to it. And that something could be a keylogger, where it actually watches the keys that you key in. It's looking for credit card numbers, it's looking for bank information and stuff like that. And so don't use pirated software, because it may contain a keylogger or some other type of malicious software that might compromise your system and allow a hacker to get in and actually see what you're doing, and you don't want that to happen. And the next tip that I want to talk about is using jump drives. You want to use just your jump drives, and if you're using other people's jump drives, that jump drive might have some malicious software that might infect your Windows 10 computer, and that would be very, very bad. So that's why you want to use your own, and you can scan these with the antivirus software, such as Super Antispyware or Malwarebytes. So another thing that I really want to stress here is your protection and your security. So don't share personal information online unless you know the site that you're sharing it with, such as let's say it's your bank or something. And you always want to check the URL address box at the top to make sure it is the actual bank that you're sharing the information with and not a phishing website, because there are so many phishing websites out there which phish information. They are phishing for your information, but they look legit. They look like a bank, or they may look like the regular site that you go to. And that's why you always want to check the URL address box at the top there and make sure that you truly are getting into your financial institution or into the other sites that you do your work or share your other information. Hey, so those are a few tips there for keeping you a little bit safer there online and with your Windows 10 computer. Now, if you have other suggestions, which I'm sure there are many ideas there, because I actually teach a class on this, and I'm usually talking about this for over an hour in my class. But here, this is just a really quick overview of some of the tips that I really stress there in class. So if you have some other ideas, please leave those in the comment section there. I really appreciate it. And give it a thumbs up if you like the video, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so already. Thank you very much, and bye-bye.